Can you tell us that?
So the story is, as Hanan mentioned before, is from the time of the Talmud. It's almost 2,000 years ago. And the story is very, very unique. And actually, I think that every child in the garden learned this story.
They learned the story in kindergarten?
Yeah.
Okay.
So the story is that one day, one of the stone of the ephod of the high priest was lost.
Mm-hmm. So and there are 12 stones, and one of them is missing.
One of them
missing. So if you're missing, you're missing the ability to address one of the,
yeah,
the tribes.
Okay. So we need this stone. So they start to look for where they can find this stone. And they heard about a Gentile. His name is Dama, Ben Netina. Dama, the son of Netina.
Okay.
Who live in Ashkelon. And they went to Ashkelon to meet this guy and knocked the door. And he said, yes. And they said, we're looking for this special stone. So he said, okay, no problem.
He has the stone.
I have it. It will cost you, we are in the States, so we talk in dollars. So he said, I want $100. So I said, okay, shake the hands. You know, take the check, write the check. And then he said, okay, so I will go up to bring the key. And then he go, he disappeared for a few seconds. And then he come back and he said, listen, I very apologize. The key is under the pillow of my father. And my father now is sleeping. Mm-hmm. So please come in 2-3 hours. I will give it to you. They look on each other and they said, okay, this is a businessman and we need this stone. So they said, okay, we will pay double. So I said, I'm sorry, it's impossible now. Come in 2-3 hours, it will be okay. They said, we will pay you 10 times, we'll pay you $1,000. And he said, I'm very sorry, I cannot now. Come in few hours and you will get it. They didn't know what to do. They left, sit in a coffee shop, waiting. And suddenly the guy arrived to them. And he said, here is the stone. So they said, okay, so we have to pay you. Here is check for $1,000. And he said, no. We agree about $100. We agree about the price. I want the price that we agree from the beginning. And they said, yeah, but we agree, later on we agree about other number. And he said, no. I don't sell my commitment of respect my parents, respect my father in money. Mm. And the Talmud end this story with a bless that this Gentile got. A year later, he had his ranch, Red Heifer. So from this story, we can learn a lot of things, how to respect our parents, how to make negotiation with honest, a lot of story. But I take from this the point that, as we said, Dama ben Netina, that he had the stone for the temple, for the ephod, he had the red heifer, he was a Gentile. And I think that this is the story today is to connect people. And I think, Hanan, you mentioned
Tai. And this is where I would tell about
and
Tai.
And you
please
now
tell
have
us
to complete
story.
This story.
So we said it, in whoever didn't listen to the first section, should listen back. But
you got to listen to the whole thing.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm just saying. So basically, going back to the Davenport brothers, we have one of them was a big cowboy, the other one came in, Brian, and then we said, what else do you do? And he said, actually, I'm a jeweler. I deal with diamonds. I'm like, what? Do you know the story of Dama ben Netina? He says, Dama ben Netina? He said, Dama ben Netina. You have to look it up on Wikipedia. So we take our phones, we show him on Wikipedia. He's like, I can't believe it. So he said, okay, let's go out. Let's go see if we can find the red heifers right over here in our ranch. And we go out that day and we find 3 kosher, beautiful red heifers that are unblemished, that are perfect. And actually, in this picture, we could see 2 of them that arrived.
Oh, man, oh, man.
So it is unreal. That is the story of Dama ben Netina in our generation.
So significance. What I'm sensing, permission to speak freely, what I'm sensing is an open door for Jewish and Gentiles to come together around something that we both Jew and Gentile would agree that this is the word of God. Now, we see that information, bring a red heifer, but it's going to take a lot of work. It's going to take a lot of resource. It's going to take a lot of creativity. It's going to take relationships. It's going to take being uncomfortable. Can I admit, when Saki says to me, hey, listen, Keith, help us. I'm coming to Charlotte. I'm like, wait, no. The timing is not right. We can't do it. How are we going to do it? And here we are. Yeah. Here we are educating everyone that's watching here about the red heifer. And so Gentile and Jewish relationships connecting around what is common is where we want people to be. This is, I actually feel like these five red heifers, at least the five of them right now, there may be more, they're bringing us together. Am I right or wrong?
Absolutely.
I mean, am I right
or wrong? May I be honest? May I be honest?
I hope you'll be honest.
Okay. Do you love archaeology? I think it's boring.
Okay. I love it.
Okay.
I think it's boring because it's a stone. The magnificent thing is the story behind the stone.
Yes.
Amen.
And I think that what we're going to do in Shiloh, that is, this is also boring archaeologic place, but it's amazing story. It's amazing story about nation that create from tribes to one nation. Mm. And the second step was to build a temple. Until Samuel, the prophet Samuel, bring Saul and then David to be the king, there was 12 tribes. Mm. We know even that there was a war between them. There was a lot of problem. But Samuel, what he do, he made a tribes to a nation. Mm. And therefore, the tabernacle and tent can go to the real place, to Jerusalem.
Wow.
And to be the temple. Mm-hmm. I think that what we're going to do together in Shiloh, together with you, is to build a visitor center that will not be about cows. Mm-hmm. We are not a zoo. Mm-hmm. We want to do a visitor center that will give the people the understanding and to open their eyes and to see how all the fruit in Israel now is amazing. Mm-hmm. Like the prophet said,
Ve'atem
hare Israel anchvechem titnu peri. All your land will be with fruit. Mm-hmm. And we want to show people that Israel is not, even though that there is only 76 years now, 75 and a half, it's a huge technology place, mm-hmm. economy succeed. And for me, it's a miracle. Mm-hmm. And this visitor center that we're going to build is actually to let people understand that we are in the redemption time.
Now, you guys, I want to give each of you a chance to talk to our friends. How can, and let me tell you something, the first time I met Saki, I asked him this question four times, and he wouldn't answer it right off the top. How can we help? He says, pray for us. How can we help? Pray for us, he says. Okay, we'll pray for you. Now, how can we help? So, how can people, and I like to say it this way, for the sake of the picture, the ceremony, whenever it takes place, will be conducted by Maestro in heaven.
Yes.
He'll raise his hands and go like this, and everyone will have an instrument. You all have instruments that you've been playing now for how many years? You've been playing your instrument. But there's more instruments that are going to come, and it's going to be a beautiful symphony, a beautiful symphony. Now, one by one, I want to start with you, Hanan. Talk to the people. How can they join in? How can they help? What can they do? Is there any way that they can feel as connected as I do? I just met you in less than an hour and a half, and I feel like we're brothers. I feel like I'm like, I am just excited. Byron, I talked to him one time on the phone. I feel like I've known him. He's like my uncle or something like that. Saki, I don't know about him. He's really made me uncomfortable.
But no, we have a war between us.
Yeah, a war between us. How can people help? Hanan, act like someone's sitting there right now and they're Dama Ben Natina. How can he help? What can he do?
Maybe I have to, I must say something. You know, all the time I said to people when we are talking about that, I said, you have two options. One option is to sit in the soap, watch the movie, maybe cry, maybe complain, maybe. This is one way. it's good. It's nice, even you can eat popcorn. So it's became to be beauty. And you have the other way. And the other way is to wake up and to be part of this movie, to be part of this journey. Mm. And I think that we fly too much hours, I think. I don't know how many hours we've been in the plant in the last days, but we fly here to say, come up, wake up, came from the soap, and come and join to the journey. It's not Tzachi project, it's not Byron project, it's not Hanan project, it's even not Bone Israel project. It's a world project. And I hope that people that see us, first of all, learn about it. It's important to learn the order and what's written in the Bible. So this is first of all, this is very good to learn. And second, I hope that people will join us.
Amen. So for the church, what I see they can do is understand that God is spiritual, but more importantly, right now, if you want to look at Israel, you need to understand it's also physical. Our Jewish fathers of the faith, they see things a lot more physical than we do, and the way that we can get there is by really studying and understanding what the Old Testament says. Now, we have a lot of resources to help you see that. One of the places you can go is to the Bone Israel Facebook page. We're putting posts there every day just about, and we'd like for you to share and like that so that your neighbors and other people can see this information. And then we have a website for Bone Israel also. Okay. We have a donation link if you'd like to drop in there and give us $30 million so that we can do the next step.
I'm in.
Yeah, let's do that. Or even if you want to give us $2, that's okay. It means just as much as the guy that gave $30. There's no difference. And really, I'd rather see 1 million people give $2 each than the one guy give $20 million, to be honest with you. So please come and support this. Be part of it physically. Step into the story and be part of us. And let's do this together. Let's see the Messiah come because of our love for him and our love for the Bible and our love for each other. And let's see him come because he's pleased with what we're doing.
I would like to say, actually, a sad thing is that this year, actually, the suicidal rates have gone sky high. And there's different reasons, as people say, the research has shown also. It could be social media, it could be COVID definitely also enhanced it. And I think that one of the things that the Red Heifer actually is doing is the exact opposite. What it's doing is taking away, number one, this iPhone, iPad, I know, I'm in the center, I have to understand everything. Just saying, you know what? There's something divine, there's something greater than just us. Hmm. That's number one. On the other hand, or maybe another hand, is that each and every one of us is born into this world, and we have a mission, and we have a purpose. We, each one of you that are watching now this show, we all have a purpose. And when we come together, amen, that's when the strength comes. Amen. And I think that over 2,000 years, we spoke about this. I mean, you said 90%, I think maybe 95% we agree on. And it's time that we come together with real peace, not just to say, oh yeah, real peace and love, and say, you know what? Yeah. We need to come back to Jerusalem, to Yerushalayim, where my house of prayer will be a house of prayer for all the nations. It's not just, he's not just a Jew's God, he's the whole world's God.
Amen.
And therefore, I think that this is what God had his ways of saying, you know, this Red Heifer is something that's so like ludicrous in a certain way, right? For us, our normal way of thinking, all of a sudden we're starting to say, you know what? Actually, it's doing many things at once. It's bringing us a lot closer, and we could start to work together. Amen. And with the same purpose, and we all out there, we really want this world to, as we say in Hebrew, we want to do a tikkun olam. We want to fix this world b'malchut Hashem. In Hashem's name, we want this world to be a better place. So let us all work together. And when I actually truly mean this, that all of us should be the best in what we're doing, but in the right way. And together we could fix this world and making it the best place on heaven's earth.
Amen, amen. I want a scripture to read. Ezekiel 36:25, therefore, then I will sprinkle clean water on you. Clean water from?
Yeah.
And you will be clean. I will cleanse you from all your filthiness and from all your idols. Moreover, I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. And I will remove the heart of stone from your flesh and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in. What is that Hebrew word right there?
Bechokai.
Which are the statutes. Chukat? HaTorah. Okay. And you will be careful to observe my ordinances.
Yes.
Can I blow this shofar and see if anyone that listens, if your heart is moved, if your spirit is moved, that you might join us in the process of revealing the mystery of the red heifer?
Yes.
Amen.
Let the trumpet sound.
And amen. I want to thank you all, Tzaki, Byron, Rabbi Hanan. You guys, I consider you as friends. Eventually, I'll get one of those planes with you, but not today. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for coming. We're going to do a couple other things just to help people know about this. If you see this episode, share it, like it, do everything you can to send it to everyone, that people will help us join together on a common mission. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Toda rabba.
Thank you.
Toda rabba.
各位末世烽火台观众们平安，现在是12月31号2022年2:20凌晨。今天我跟各位分享我看的我们最新发布的 The Mystery of Red Heifer Revealed 的中文字幕版，由 Keith Johnson 牧师他所精心制作的。那么这一集以后呢，我来跟各位分享我的领受。这真的是一段奇妙又精妙的过程，看见上帝的导演这一出末世时空大戏啊。 OK， 各位还记得上一集我提到圣殿重建院创办人 Ariel Labi， OK， 那他就直接呢 involve 在这一个整个过程当中的。那么记得吗，他1967年啊，他是首批啊收复圣殿山的时候空降圣殿山的其中的一员啊。OK， 而且呢，在1986年呢，他就因为有这个经历，他就呢启动了那个圣殿重建院 Temple Institute， 然后呢开始启动这个 Dare to Build 圣殿重建运动。因为有这个圣殿山的收复，然后呢才启动了这一个圣殿重建运动。那么之后呢，这两位拉比嘛，哈，犹太拉比这个 Tzaki 跟这个 Hanan。那他们就出现之后呢，他们居然跟外邦的基督徒这个 拜伦啊协力来合作寻找红苹果，这个事情实在是很有意义的。为什么？因为不相信耶稣是以色列人的弥赛亚的拉比们，跟相信耶稣是以色列人跟外邦人的弥赛亚的基督徒协力合作来寻找红母牛，所以上帝很奇妙，就使用这个红母牛呢，来连接了这两个不同的族群在一起的，而且呢，共同来寻找红母牛。然后让令人更惊讶的是什么？他们所寻找的红母牛的那个农场，的那个主人那个泰，他的上一代，他们都是基督徒了，泰也是基督徒。然后泰他们的上一代，照他自己的分享，为什么他的上一代呢，决定呢要来开农场？要来牧养牛，可是呢在不同的牛种当中呢，他们就是选择要来牧养 Angus 这个牛。那为什么？因为他们说那个我们要来培养红母牛，因为 Angus 牛呢它本身呢是红的，红色的。那么所以说他们说要来培养红母牛啦。为什么？他说因为圣经里面有提到过，而且呢他们相信说也许有一天如果神要用的话，也许有一天的耶路撒冷呢会用到他们这一个农场里面所饲养出来的纯红的红母牛。哇，各位，这是什么样的心愿啊？这在那个几十年前就想到这个，这样子的感动是从哪里来的？ OK， 然后呢他的这个下一代呢就持续的这个一个事业跟这个心愿，结果真的上帝就赐给他们红母牛，真的就可以到耶路撒冷来使用。哇，各位，就要看到上帝的手在这样子的不同的世代当中穿越时空啊，但是呢精妙的把许多的点连接起来，然后呢为了要完成他自己的旨意。 那么这里面呢，我们末世先锋呢也是非常的荣幸，对不对？好、哦，有这样子奇遇记，就这样子巧妙的跟他们就这样认识了，而且有被赋予这样的托付说，说 OK 给我们首发他们节目的综艺 ，OK。那么而且呢，受邀参与2023年这2000多年来的第一次献红母的仪式啊。这可见呢，就说我们这华人啊，这个族群啊，在这个神的心意里面跟这旨意里面是如何的，就是受到重视。OK， 也就是因为这样，上帝把这个他们也重视华人的参与，不管在西方的基督徒里面，或者是这个犹太拉比们，都一样都是重视这个华人的参与。OK， 这个就是我们华人在末世真的是有很大的命定。好，各位，那么另外呢，还有一个奇遇点哈，就是呢，各位。10个外邦人事工啊，那这个我要提一下，各位看照片里面哈，从左边算过来第三位哈，那一位华人他叫 David 董弟兄，那再到后面的那一位就是 Byron 嘛哈，那个白人穿白衬衫的，那个是 Byron， 他是寻找到帮助那个拉比们寻找到红母牛的。好，那么我们在那边聊天的时候啊，很奇妙的，那我介绍了 David 董。那 David 董呢，就是也是我拜访 Michael Roo 这一次去拜访他的时候呢，那个才认识David 董弟兄。那他很热情招待我好几天，那就载我去了这个 Michael Roo 的这个摄影棚嘛。那就因为这样子，那他也就直接认识这些人。那么结果我在介绍 David 董的时候呢，我说他有支持 David 董呢，他们支持了一个他们自己的事工啊，叫做10个外邦人事工。那他们所做的主要事情就是在以色列呢这些华人的同工们在那里呢服侍当地的以色列人。好，那结果这个 Byron 啊，他就说，诶，他说我要来的时候我才刚刚认识一个姐妹，华人姐妹，然后呢他说他是 10 Gentile Ministry， 就10个外邦人事工。我说好，真的有这种事情吗？天下如此之大 ，OK， 怎么会有这么巧妙、这么奇妙的事情呢？哎，然后就把照片拿出来看，一看那个 David 董弟兄说：“哇，对啊，这是我们的同工啊，怎么就是在这个时间点跟这个地点上面如此精妙的这个都凑合起来了？”好，那这个10个外邦人事工，他们的经文出处啊，就是撒迦利亚书8:23，那就讲到说这个。在末后的日子里面会有10个外邦人啊，然后呢会来到以色列，然后呢会拉住一个犹太人的衣襟啊，说什么我们要与你们同去，因为我们听见神与你们同在的。哎，这个就很有末世指标性的意义哦，因为紧接着我会跟大家分享以色列属灵的大复兴呢会造成祝福许多的外邦人，那也因为这样子呢才会有这个撒迦利亚书8:23这个10个外邦人的这一个预言。好，那么所以呢在整个过程里面我就看到说，哇，这个上帝拣选对他话语认真的人，那你像这些比如说这个 Byron 啊，他帮助这个拉比们来寻找这个红母牛，那个过程啊大家也看了，真的是千辛万苦啊，非常不容易，可是呢上帝知道，他也信任他自己所拣选的，他知道他们的心啊，所以完成他们的旨意啊，那也给他们奖赏。好，那接下来重中之重，以西结书36:2将在我们面前啊照字面应验，末日时辰加速推进。这个呢就是我看了这一集以后啊，哇，他们这个当这个哈南拉比他提到以西结书36:2的时候，哇，我眼前一亮，哇，好像打通任督二脉一样，说哎呀，我过去研究红母牛说没有看到这一点啊，哇，对啊，是什么意思呢？哇，就是说神对以色列有个末日救赎计划，它有5部曲 ，OK， 5部曲。那么呢，这一个红母牛啊的灰所做的这个出污水，哇，这个占了一个非常重要的一个地位。好，那么所以呢，在我们的眼前啊，我们将会看到这一个预言的应验哦。好，因为红母牛的出现哦，那各位，所以在这里呢，白伦就特别提醒说，醒醒啊，沉睡的教会们，我们不要再把圣经里面关于那个末世的预言啊，把它给灵异化了，好像跟我们这个世界上真实的世界上面，在眼前我们所发生的时事呢，啊，一点都没有什么关联的，错了， 上帝的话语呢是真实的，是信实的，而且是在我们眼前呢是照字面应验。当我们明白这个了以后，我们就会让我们非常的警醒，而且呢心里面有热切的盼望，而且知道说我们现在在神的末世计划的时间线上面的哪一个点，而且随着他心意跟旨意跟神一起来配合，一起来同工，一起来行动。好，所以呢以色列末日救赎计划的五部曲是什么？第一步是收取归回。那么以西结书36:24就直接讲了，引导你们归回本地，从外邦啊却归回。那么从1948年5月14号一直到现在2022年的尾声了，最后一天了，哇，结果是怎样？结果就是那个已经有600,000,000的以色列人回归，那么还在继续回归当中，所以这个已经是应验了。那第二部曲是什么？然后就是在第25节，哇，计划都写出来。然后那我为什么加这个然后？因为在 King James 里面版本有一个 then then， 然后我必用清水洒在你们身上，那么你们就洁净。好，所以神就要洁净以色列民。哇哦，那用什么洁净？就是用红母牛的灰去烧了以后做成了那个除污的水啦。那只有这样子吗？不是啦，因为哈，当这一个第二步用除污水来洁净红母牛的灰，红母牛出现以后，那就是这第二部曲。好，洁净，洁净了以后，第三部曲是什么？换心手术，上帝呢，直接呢换心脏的，换心手术了哈。所以上帝呢，直接对以色列呢执行换心手术啊！哇哦，什么叫换心手术？紧接26节啊，讲什么？我要给你们一个新的心啊！哇哦，为什么？而且这个有个换心的过程是什么？从你们的肉体当中什么？除掉你们很坚硬的那个石头的心啊，然后呢赐给你们肉心，所以它是一个换心的一个手续啊。哇，换了心手续又会产生什么事情？哦，各位啊，越讲越兴奋，会产生以色列的属灵大复兴啊，以色列民就会甘心乐意顺从那个耶和华神的话语。这怎么讲呢？因为紧接27节他就讲嘛，换心手术完成以后，上帝呢，哇哦，把上帝自己的灵啊放在以色列民里面，呵呵，这样子呢以色列民就会顺从，甘心乐意顺从他的律例，谨守遵行他的典章啊。这个就是以色列的属灵的大复兴啊，这个也是在以西结书后面37章38章我们就会看到，你们就会看到那个上帝呢叫以西结呢第二次对枯骨平原里面的那些枯骨里面吹气嘛，第二次吹气，第二次发预言的时候，上帝叫他吹气，上帝的灵进到里面，他们就起来成为一个那个极大的军队，那个是以色列的属灵大复兴，因为神的灵吹进去。那1948年的以色列复国，那个是那个第一次上帝叫以西结第一次发预言，那个是那个属肉体的再现，照神的这个属灵的这个做法呢，就是属灵的规则呢，就是属肉体的在先，属灵的在后。所以以色列呢复国了，好，这个 natural 这个自然界的事情先发生，然后呢怎么样？第二次好再发预言，那么怎么样？神的灵进去了， OK， 那个就是属灵大复兴，属灵的在后。好，那么呢结果这样子呢就会完成第五部曲，完成亚伯拉罕之约啊，所以以色列民呢就永居应许之地。那么呢各位，就在我们的眼前啊，以西结书36章27节的第二部曲呢，它即将会启动，当它一发生了以后呢，它会启动弥迦书的4章的第1节跟第2节，那就跟我们外邦人大有关系。为什么？因为呢以色列的属灵大复兴啊，它会带来外邦人的外邦的属灵的复兴啊， OK， 为什么这么讲呢？就是弥迦书的4章第1节跟第2节，你看末后的日子有没有讲到，就 The last days 嘛，就是在这个末世主要回来之前，对不对？这段的时空。好，那么耶和华殿的山必坚立，大家看到吗？对，耶和华的殿，好，超乎诸山，然后呢万民都要流归这山，好，都要来到这里来，而且呢有许多国的民迁往，这都走指外邦的嘛，包括我们华人嘛，齁，好，来吧，我们登耶和华的山，然后什么奔雅各神的殿。哇，大家看到，所以呢再一次讲，这个不见得就是石头盖起来的圣殿，也许呢就是 The Tabernacle David， 大卫的帐幕来那个跟约柜显现出来。好，这个也会是神的殿。好，然后呢，为什么我们这些外邦人呢都会要来到耶路撒冷呢？为什么？因为知道什么？主必将他的道，因为他渴慕神的话语啊，主必将他的道教训我们，我们也要行他的路啊。好，然后为什么？因为训诲必出于锡安，训诲那原文叫妥拉，就耶和华神自己的话语。好，必出于锡安，然后呢，耶和华的言语必出于耶路撒冷。所以各位，我们现在就活在这样子的一个惊天动地、惊心动魄的末世时空当中，那么看着这个上帝将这个隐藏在历史历代的这个预言里面，写在圣经里面的预言里面，到了时间逐步接近的时候，就随着时间的来到 the hour 那个 kairos moment 的来到的时候呢，哇，上帝呢就把他的旨意、他的心意，照着世界上所发生的这个事情啊，然后呢，在我们眼前啊，就把这一他的这个旨意、心意、他的预言中的这个奥秘，再向我们来展开来，好让我们呢能够在这个末世当中呢活得精彩，活得有意义，活得有呼召，活得有方向感，而且活得每天都好像热腾腾的刚出炉的包子一样啊！各位，我们实在很有幸，尤其是身为华人基督徒啊，在这个末世时空当中，各位，哎呀，兴奋啊！各位，我们期待一起，各位，我们随着2023年的来到，我们一起来领受神对我们的呼召，而且呢，来踏入我们的呼召，我们共同勉励，共同的来同工。节目尾声跟各位分享最后一点，拉比哈南他有提到说，当他们红母牛到达以色列的时候，那一天就刚好是整整两年前的一天不差一天不多，就是亚伯拉罕合约 The Abraham Accord 成立的时候。各位，这不是一切都不是巧合的，各位还记得吗？我跟各位有分享过，神对以色列的末日的救恩计划里面，就是以色列的全家得救的奥秘跟亚伯拉罕合约是有极为密切的关系的。那因为这样子呢，这个亚伯拉罕的后裔，亚伯的后裔，我讲的就是以撒的后裔跟以实玛利的后裔哦，就是中东的这些以实玛利的后裔，他们呢也要怎么样来信耶和华神。 OK， 因为这个亚伯拉罕合约的促成，好，那么这个呢就会启动以色列全家得救的奥秘。那么关于这一点呢，我也录制了一集的节目，那么呢我们的同工正在剪接，那我们之后会播放出来。那么这个是也是一个非常重要的在末世当中我们需要领受的那个神的心意跟他明白他的计划。好，那本集末世烽火台到此结束，谢谢各位收听，我们下一集再会，愿神祝福你。